You're watching Cable 13, the lucky number for you. It wasn't supposed to be close, and it wasn't, as Syracuse dominated Colgate 20-3 earlier this week. But all eyes were on the man who wears number one, Tim Nelson. He came up with 3 goals and 1 assist, 4 points in all, to leave him just 1 point shy of the all-time scoring mark held by Cornell graduate Mike French. And today, the man who wears number one can become number one simply by picking up any combination of goals and assists totaling 2. As we bring you live action from the Carrier Dome, Syracuse Lacrosse. Rogers Cable Systems and Cable 13 Sports presents Syracuse University Lacrosse. Today, live from the Carrier Dome, it's the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers and the Orange Men of Syracuse. Today's game is brought to you by Callet Copy Products. See the complete line of Canon and Toshiba copiers at our new location, Erie Boulevard West. By Fagan's, for the perfect blend of dining and drinking in a delightful atmosphere. By Syracuse Plywood, the inside story, more than the name implies. By DiNardo Ford, the Southwest County Ford dealer in Skinny Atlas. By Network Video, the leader in home video entertainment. And by RJ O'Toole's, offering lunch, dinner, and drinks in an atmosphere of good taste. It's a beautiful day in late spring here in Syracuse. A little bit on the nippy side, and inside the Carrier Dome, of course, conditions are ideal for lacrosse or any sport. And speaking of sports, we've had ourselves quite a week with football, bowling, tennis, and today the first live cable cast of a locally produced Syracuse University event, and it turns out to be lacrosse, Syracuse Orange style from the Carrier Dome. Hello again, everybody. I'm Dave Cohen, along with Dale Dreipulcher. Syracuse with a record of 9-1 against Rutgers. They've also played 10 games. They've won 7, lost 3, and Rutgers faces a must-win situation, Dale.
Yeah, they do. If they want to make the playoffs, this is a big game for them. They've got some people that can do it, but it's going to be difficult for them. One man we might want to talk about is number 14, Ed Trabulsi. He is their leading scorer. He had 33 points coming into this game, and he's also one of their leading ground ball men. He'll pick up the ground balls. Second man that we'll want to talk about, there's Ed right there, number 14. Second man we're going to talk about will be Brian Crost, and he'll pop in the picture. There's Brian right there. He's got 32 total points. He also second in ground balls, and a real hustler out there for Rutgers. The man that perhaps the key is right there, John Neslansky, number 2, the goalie. Coming into this game, he's been an honorable mention All-American. He's got almost just under 60% save ratio, and he's a man that is really going to be the key.
Syracuse with some good sophomore play out of Todd Curry from West Genesee. He's accounted for 28 points, 15 goals on the year. And Gordy Mapes, who's splitting time with Tom Corey on the attack. Gordy from Rochester with 11 goals, 12 assists, and 23 points. They are occasionally on the attack, along with a man who wears number one, Tim Nelson, whose brother, by the way, Scott Nelson, is an assistant coach for Rutgers, and his other brother, Tom, is also another attack man for Syracuse. So it'll kind of be all in the family today for the Nelsons, and we'll keep you posted on the progress of Tim. He only needs 2 points to break the all-time mark. Defensively, what do you suppose Rutgers might try to do?
Well, you know, they've tried a lot against Nelson, both of them, but Tim, obviously, today is the man that they're going to be looking for. There's really not much you can do. He's big. He's strong. You might be able to deny him the goals, but he's going to get those assists, and they all count. I think that it's just going to be they're going to have to play their game, try to play him tough defensively. They'll probably give him the body occasionally, but just try to shut him down. Whether or not they can do it, nobody else has, not consistently for a whole game.
Rutgers also comes in with a number of local players. We'll tell you about that and the fact that Rutgers has a dome of their own when we come back with Syracuse Rutgers Lacrosse live on Cable 13. You're watching Cable 13, the lucky number for you. Live in the Carrier Dome, Syracuse and Rutgers have just been introduced to the crowds as they get set to meet for the first time this season. A year ago, they played twice. Syracuse won the regular season game 15-12, and then in overtime, the playoff game here in the Dome 8-7. Right now, our national anthem. Thank you. Syracuse with only one loss in 10 games, that to Johns Hopkins, the defending national champions, by a score of 8-6. The Orange have defeated North Carolina, Delaware, Army, Cortland State, Penn State, Adelphi, Harvard, Cornell, and Colgate, with a record of 9-1, averaging 15 goals per game. Tom Hayes, the head coach of the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. The Rutgers Scarlet Knights have a number of local players who are returning home today. Brad Ruse out of Homer, New York, who may see only limited action because he has a broken toe. Brad Fish out of Fayetteville, and Eric Dotter from right here in Syracuse, graduate of Henninger.
As they get set and we look at the ledger for Rutgers, they lost to Army 12-8, and Army always a tough team, but some of their wins have come against teams that are less than spectacular, which really puts pressure on them to beat a Syracuse in order to make it into the playoffs, Dave. So as we said at the top of the show, this is a really important game for Rutgers if they want to make the playoffs.
The lineup for Rutgers, they'll start with Brad Fish, Jeff Lynch, and Brian Crost on the attack, Tim Donovan, Dave DeSherio, and Greg Freed of the midfield, Jeff Mayock, Rick Lewis, and Lewis Trapp on defense, and in the goal will be John Nislonsky. Syracuse will open up on the attack with Nelson, and Corey. Curry, Kotz in the midfield along with Lenuto on defense. Desco, Sheehan, O'Donnell, and the goalie is Tom Nims.
DeSherio is going to be facing off from Yorktown for Rutgers, and Brad Kotz, number 30, in his familiar position, usually starts facing off.
But with an unfamiliar leg bandage on his right leg. We're underway live from the Carrier Dome. Hope you enjoy it here on Cable 13. Michael Donnell with a big stick, overthrowing downfield, but Syracuse keeps it in their possession as Tom Nelson gets it to Kotz on the wing, intended for Kotz on the return.
That's Brannigan in
Brannigan
there now, I believe.
Yeah. Quickly, yeah. Here's Todd Curry, number 16. Getting defensive pressure there from a big stick. Rutgers players in there. Tom Martello. Martello is a player who plays midfield, attack, defense. He's all over the field. DeSherio is 26.
You watch Bayek playing defense on Nelson. He's all over him. He's just face guarding him. He's fronting him, backing him. He's not letting him do anything. There's number 32. You'll see him in the picture as Nelson gets the ball. There's the defenseman. He's only 5'10", so he's giving away some height, but he is playing Nelson very, very tough, very, very early.
Tim Nelson directing his team to move around.
And we'll
an interesting alignment.
They're
going
to double him. Yeah, they're going to double him on the pass in. And they get the ball into Sheehan, who came across. Corey down, falling.
And Sheehan racing with it as it goes out of bounds. Pat Dawson was there for Rutgers. And we'll get changes made by both sides. Let's go back to that throw-in, Dale, because it was very unusual.
Well, you don't have to throw the ball, and of course you can run it in, but they certainly, when they had him like that, what they wanted to do is double him there, so it looks like they're going to try to deny the ball to Tim Nelson, whether it be passing or him passing.
Now Rutgers walks it up with John Nislonsky.
They've got a lot of people
providing some pressure.
A lot of people back on this to make sure they can get the clear. They had six men back.
Matt Cacciato was on the ride there. Loose at midfield. He gets beyond an orange stick of Kevin Sheehan. And Rutgers controls it now. Here come the Scarlet Knights. DeSherio not yet into the box.
Flag down also. Syracuse.
Number 30 is Greg Freed. He has a bruised ankle. As he dumps in front.
That should stop it right there.
Intended again for number 18, Donovan.
Offside, we could clearly see that Syracuse did not have the required three men on the offensive half of the field. So they will start out early. A minute and 42 seconds into this game, they'll be man down for 30 seconds.
John Desco is the assistant coach to Roy Simmons. Out it goes now. Trabulsi's in. As is Brad Ruse, number 3. There's Ruse handling it. Swinging it to DeSherio, and they move it around in a clockwise fashion. Man advantage right here for Rutgers. They move in close on Nims, and Tom Nims gathers it in off the weak shot by Ed Trabulsi. Now O'Donnell redirecting it.
Trabulsi tried to sneak it, didn't work, and they got the ball into Nims, who will now set it up. The penalty should be over. It is right now. So they are even. Back in to the goalie, and he'll set up to clear.
Rutgers keeps the pressure on. Now they relax it somewhat. And Tom Nims throws it across midfield. Nice pass by Nims. It's in the stick of a defenseman.
It's Pratt, I believe. Bad pass.
Overthrowing Todd Curry. And fast picked break. Up by Trabolsi now. Good check from behind by Brannigan. Rolls it ahead, and it's scooped up by Cambria.
Both teams a little bit sloppy here in the beginning of the game. Long pass again, so we've seen a lot of long passes by Syracuse.
Neither team with a good shot on goal yet. And the passing, a little bit suspect. Cox in front, the shot, the save. Brannigan, Zlansky, the rebound is in.
Whistle.
It will not count.
Now, there was a whistle long before then. And we've got Phil Natoli, one of the officials on the bench side. He is not, we'll see the procedure call right there by Jim O'Hara, but Phil Natoli is the official. And last week we had that long discussion against Cornell's. They put an official in there. It's not technically a three-man game. And we'll see the shot by Brannigan right off of the goalie, Neslansky. But there was a whistle.
No goal, 30-second penalty.
Too many men on the field is the call, so an illegal procedure technically.
And we can see right in front of us, there's Jim O'Hara. You see the Rutgers coach complaining.
Hayes, yeah.
Yeah, he was complaining strenuously, but to no avail.
They put it back in motion, the clock. Here's Tim Nelson out of Todd Curry.
They have nobody behind. Syracuse has everybody out front.
Rutgers packing it in. Now, Corey is 42, Dale, and this is Curry now getting it.
Nelson cleared through and has gone behind. Usually on the extra man, he is out at the top, but there he is handling the ball from behind.
Emmett Pritt up in the game, number 7, throwing back outside to Curry. And now Kotz. And again, they move it behind to Nelson. His feet in front is deflected, taken away by the Scarlet Knights. Rick Lewis, 35, goes back to Nislotsky. He'll get pressure from both Nelsons, but he gets it upfield. We're in the first quarter. We've played close to 4 minutes. There is no score.
They're even. Both teams changing on the fly as Nislotsky holds the ball. And there you can see some of the players coming in.
Greg Freed picks it up now.
Freed just came in from the bench as they get their offensive middies out.
Goes by Tom Nelson. Pridham takes a run at him. Nice one-handed pass ahead. And Rutgers into the box with a high pass, overthrown, but it stays in. Now a whistle. Flag is thrown way up at midfield. It's an offsides call.
Syracuse.
Offsides. Syracuse looking like they've had a little more time off than perhaps they'd like in a tough game. Look, a little sloppy here early. In terms of penalties, they've had, that's the second offside penalty.
Now they put it in play again, the Scarlet Knights, who have yet to put a real good shot on goal yet.
Man up in this situation.
Brad Ruse is number 3. He's from Homer. And here he is with the ball. And he gets it again. Now Syracuse will take a run at the man behind the cage. They're moving in for a good shot. Again, you can see Rutgers using that same strategy we saw Cornell use a couple of weeks ago.
He'll stack the crease, try to cover up the vision of the goalie, and then when the shot's taken, they try to jump out of the way. We see the back of Coach Simmons and John Desko as they change on the fly. Syracuse, good hustle on the ball, on the shot, will give them the ball. You watch the crease. There's the two men. Watch them both go up in the air, and there's the shot going down low. What they're trying to do is screen the goalie, and Nims' ball bounced out. Syracuse very alertly pounced on the rebound, got to the out of bounds before Rutgers, so they're now going to clear the ball.
Good legs on the part of that 16,
Curry.
Curry,
yes. Curry gets the ball in, down to Tom Nelson.
Team's changed now. Eric Jeschke comes on and gets it immediately, number 11.
Running a lot of midfields. Schmoller in now, 21 will come into your picture in a second as he checks in.
And Rhett Cavanaugh, number 13, transfer out of West Point.
And there you see Bayek all over Nelson, ball down on the ground. Rhett Cavanaugh up with a ground ball.
Cavanaugh sets it up again as he throws to this side to Schmoller. Schmoller behind the cage for Nelson.
Boy, they're really not letting him move on that crease.
That's Tom Nelson. Now we get some action in front of the crease.
I think Tim Nelson's going to have be called for an illegal check. And watch the movement or the lack of movement on the crease, Dave. Watch what happens. They're not, see, Bayek is guarding him really tight. You see that number 31, actually, Dawson, came up first, but of course, as in most sports, it's usually the second guy that gets caught. So unnecessary roughness will cost Syracuse the ball, and they obviously the Rutgers strategy is to crowd the crease up and not let anybody move. It looks like rush hour in Grand Central Station up there.
Good defensive game, Rutgers and Syracuse. No score. We've got 9:15 to play first quarter. You watch it live from the Dome on Cable 13. Rutgers with Brad Ruse. DeShirio. Intended for Ruse, and they throw it away.
That's the kind of opportunity that Rutgers cannot pass up if they hope to upset Syracuse. They had a lot of time left on that penalty and just a poor pass, ball went out of bounds. So we'll see what kind of pressure they put on Syracuse. Syracuse tried to spread it out. They'll probably double somewhere on the field, if not the man with the ball, someone else. There he is. They're gonna double him. It's Curry with the ball. He takes it back.
Curry showing good legs.
He's going to have to get rid of it, though. He's drawn two or three men.
Yeah, Trabolsi came over along with DeShirio.
In the box. That releases the penalty.
Shot and a save by Mislansky. Syracuse will run it down.
Good.
And they'll keep possession.
Well, that was a good shot by the defenseman, by number 36, Danny Pratt, because they had the wing covered where the ball went out of bounds. He took a good shot. He'd gotten the ball in the box, releases the penalty, so now they're even and they've got the ball. And Nelson's going to bring it in. Bayek again, number 32. Right on him.
Nelson dropped and separated from the ball, and Mislansky takes it away. Clean play by Rutgers. Mislansky being ragged now as he comes out. And Rutgers will come up this side of the field now with Bayek, 32.
Changing on the fly. They may double the man with the ball. That's Briggs. He dumped it off again. Fred Opie's defensive midfield in, number 34.
Rick Lewis, 35, has it now. 27 is John Hutton with the ball, and Neslansky gets it. Now Syracuse relaxes a little bit. They're back at about the 30-yard line.
Cambria, Burt, and Opie in on that defensive midfield.
Under 8 minutes to play in the first quarter, and there is no score.
Sheehan up on that one, knocked that pass down. Oh, boy, there's doing some hitting down there. And I just saw he hit Kevin Sheehan, number 4, late, Brad Fish. That's going to be unnecessary. So, Dave, you can see the strategy of the game is not to lay back and let somebody else take advantage of both sides. They're going after each other. There's been elbows all over the field. And watch and see if we can't pick up. Sheehan will get rid of the ball, number 28. You see, it should happen. There he is. And then watch, Fish is coming right up at him. And as soon as he gets rid of the ball, that's a late hit. Unnecessary roughness.
He took a run at him, and it cost him. 7:40 to go, first quarter, no score. Here's Tim Nelson, Emmett Printup. Out to Curry and Kotz, and they swing it around back to Tim. We call him the surgeon for the way he operates and can slice through human flesh in the crease.
That's right, and there's a lot of it there. 42. Tommy Corey, and he takes that little crank.
Two of the hardest shots you'll ever see in lacrosse on the field at the same time, and Emmett Printup and Tom Corey, and the Orange crack the ice with 7:20 to go here in the first quarter.
But they swing the ball around. Now they reverse it back from where it came, and we should see a left-handed shot by Corey, and you can see the follow-through, Dave, on that shot, and the net follows through, too, as he really ripped the net.
1-0.
Face off to DeShorio and Rutgers.
Dale, I was going to say, in all the home games we've done, this is probably the longest Syracuse has gone before getting their first goal.
That's right.
Corey from Kotz, who needs one assist now, and has picked up that one assist to go into fifth place on the all-time assist list.
Trabolsi with the ball behind when they start it. He's the leading scorer for Rutgers. It's Desco on him.
Brad Kotz was tied with Brad Short with 68 career assists. They trail Tim O'Hara, Tim Nelson, Jeff Davis, and Randy Lundblad. DeShirio looking for the equalizer. Good pick set there by Freed.
Oh, Burton was picked right off. Lousy shot.
Nims deflected it beyond the end line.
When I say lousy shot, it was he took the bounce too far out, and Nims was all over. It didn't even get on the cage.
You want to get that short hop.
Right, not the long hop. And you see right there where it hopped, way out in front of the crease. Now we're back to live action, and Syracuse able, Burt, I believe, came up with a ground ball. That's that big stick midfield on a fast break.
Yeah, and here they come in. Now they put it in the hands of a more offensive-minded player, Tom Corey. Doesn't use the pick by Nelson, Tom Nelson.
Now everybody hustles off. There you see them right in front of the camera as they change now. The offense for Syracuse will hustle on with the big sticks for Rutgers. We'll see if they don't get a break. Yes!
Right in front. Coming into the picture quickly, right in front, Brett Kavanaugh coming in off the bench and catching Rutgers by surprise.
That's right. You can come in off the bench like that as they changed, and somebody, Red Kavanaugh, got a jump coming out of the box. Nobody picked him up, and he just sprinted into the picture, and you'll see they led him just perfectly. There's the low shot right between the legs of Nislanski. Syracuse up now by 2-0.
That was a great look and a great pass. Don't normally see a pass from that far out on a play like that, and
you can tell they
Rutgers
played together. They
knew he by surprise.
That's right, and Syracuse knew exactly. They knew where Kavanaugh was going to be, and they passed it. Looked right up. It's a lot of credit to the Syracuse offense to be looking for that.
2-0 Syracuse. DeSherios handles it a lot. Tesco came over. Nims tries to run it down. Trabulsi might have knocked it out of bounds. He did.
Good job by Nims. He hustled over, and the ball last off Trabulsi. So Tommy Nims, credit with a lot of hustle. There he is right there with his hand up in the air. A timeout now by Rutgers, I believe.
So the Scarlet Knights have taken a timeout. They're a little bit unsettled with 5 minutes and 37 seconds to play here in the first quarter. And Syracuse leading it by the score of 2-0.
Rutgers has not had a good shot, Dave. Excuse me, I'm just going to say they've really not taken a good shot on Nims. And they've been hustling for ground balls and hustling in the midfield, but not able to get a good offense going.
This is the next to last home game of the regular season, but Syracuse is playing for a home field advantage in the NCAA playoffs.
And that's very important.
Coming up on Cable 13, Sunday, May the 5th, Pennsylvania and Syracuse right here in the Dome.
Part of the youngsters, they're watching this man, a local hero, and you see all over him, defenseman number 32, Gabrick all just knocked the ball right out of his hand. Bayek is only a junior out of Garden City, Long Island, and so far he's done a good job on Nelson. But, of course, there's a lot of time left to go. Syracuse has got to be happy so far with parts of their game, but two offside penalties and giving Rutgers those man-up opportunities, not good.
Rhett Kavanaugh got that goal to put Syracuse up 2-0, and here it is again. He'll come into the picture literally the last moment.
Good job, and as you come out of the box, it only takes a step or two to beat somebody like that, and they did it. And Rhett Kavanaugh, the transfer from Army, comes up with a great goal.
After the timeout, Rutgers will put it in play, or Syracuse will put it in play, that is, in the Rutgers end.
And they're on Nims. They're not letting Nims clear it, but ball,
intended
bad pass.
For Smoller, and stolen away. May have it offsides now.
Syracuse offside again, third penalty. That won't cost him any time because there was no possession, but they, again, I think a little bit rusty in terms of playing. And the first teamers did not get much of a workout at Colgate, Dave, as you mentioned.
2-0, Syracuse leading Rutgers. Here we go. Sheehan playing against Brian Kroos. Nims getting help in the crease. Jeff Desko with the defensive pressure applied to Ed Trabulsi. Over the top of the head, the feet in front, the shot shoveled wide.
Should cost him a hold.
We'll get a call now against Syracuse.
I think. Let's see. Yeah, they're trying to get the number. It's Desko, and they got him with a hold as he went up over the head of Trabulsi and impeded his progress. If you can make contact with a stick, that's fine. The shot went awry, but they were able to pick up 30 seconds on that.
The official there, Jim O'Hara, from a well-known lacrosse family locally.
Yeah, you've heard that name. West Genesee, of course, Syracuse, comprised of a lot of players from local high schools, West Genesee being one of the most locally heavily recruited.
Jim, the brother of Tim and BJ?
All the same.
Tim, who played at Syracuse, BJ, who played at Hobart.
Man up now as they whip the ball around the outside.
4.5 to play, first quarter. Rutgers looking to pull within one.
Sheehan doing a good job defensively for Syracuse. He hit Trabulsi, and Trabulsi lost the ball off a stick, out of bounds. Syracuse will get the ball and have to clear it. We'll see if the strategy is to play hard on the man with the ball, and it looks to be that way. They send Craig Tomsky, number 11, over right where the ball is going to come in with Nims. They're going to double Nims, or at least looks like they're going to.
Defenseman goes back to help out, Jeff Desko. Now Nims goes toward the cage. Desko will try the far sideline.
They're obviously going to really put some pressure on the ride. They saw Syracuse early in the season a little bit weak on their clearing and want to force maybe Nims to make a mistake, but he hasn't had any problems with that since very early in the season. They get up to Sheehan. They're overloaded on that side. He should be open. Curry
swings it to the right side. Sheehan was dumped after the pass, and he's slow getting to his feet.
Syracuse,
he's okay now.
Manages to come up with the ball, however.
Brad Kotz.
And we'll watch that crease action again. Before, they were just clogging the crease right up.
Corey using the pick by Tim Nelson and using it again, trying to peel his man off.
Bayek not even paying any attention to Corey when he comes by. He is just guarding Nelson with the stick. Sometimes, you know, when they run that pick, the man who's being picked will reach a stick out, but he's just staying right with Nelson. Nelson behind, and now this is Kotz out at the top as they using a 1-4-1. Nelson starting it behind, and now Kotz on just an iso.
Kotz accelerating and dishing off to Corey.
Maybe we can get a shot eventually of Bayek back there face guarding Nelson.
Is that legal to face guard?
Oh, sure. Yeah, you can do that.
Nelson, good move to get away from his man. Now he gets the step, the dump off, the pass. Yes! Four.
You can only do it for so long. That ties him. He got an assist on that.
Well, he made a great move without the ball to get away from his man. Shake and go, and he got free and found Todd Curry in front.
Absolutely right, Dave. It's very important to move without the ball, and we'll see right there. We didn't see it, but we'll see the end of it as he made the move to get away from Bayek. And does a great, there he is. What a great camera shot that was. And there's the feed, and you see the result of the feed, but the important thing was how Nelson moved without the ball.
We'll have to save that one because that is a textbook demonstration of moving without the ball to get free. And it culminated in the third Syracuse goal. They lead it now 3-0, and that's the statistical update on Tim Nelson. One away.
That gives him 296 points in his career. 92 goals and 204 assists.
3-0 Syracuse, which is the most important stat. Gordy Mapes is on now. Ooh, he took a hard shot. Legal,
boy.
Clean. He gets up, and he still has control. Now he's separated. He'll try to retaliate.
That was Lewis Trapp, the defenseman who got the ball out. He was the one that initially put Gordy down.
Lewis redirects to Nislanski.
Back to Trapp.
We're in the final 2.5 minutes of the first quarter. It's 2-0 Syracuse. 3-0.
They're going to settle it down now and set up a planned clear, no fast break. They send Trapp way over on the wing, 36. Nislanski with the ball. Rutgers doing a lot of shifting at the midfield, looking for an open man.
Killing off time now. They've had it about 30 seconds and have yet to get across.
Yeah, well, they're slowing down the pace a little bit here.
Lewis. There's Nislanski coming back. As you look at it from the end zone, Sean Hutton, 27, back there as well.
We see a long pass now. They've got number 10 way down here, Jeff Lynch, but they being covered by
instead, they give it to Hutton. And now they're moving it up quickly with Briggs.
He may have to run it across. Good defense by Nelson and Nelson.
Gene Johnson sends back to Nislanski.
A lot of trouble for Rutgers clearing the ball.
They've killed a minute off, and now they go into the attacking zone with Hutton bringing it across. John Hutton into the box.
Clock is on the field as we've got all, actually a little bit more than a minute now, but they run on to alert the official when there is 1 minute right now, 1 minute and counting.
Andy Briggs, 24. With 27, Hutton getting it now. Syracuse going man for man.
Syracuse doing a heck of a job defensively in this first quarter.
Ryan Crose, 29, hasn't really been in the offense. Now down to 39 seconds. Look at Desco take away the angle.
Yeah, right on Trabulsi. He's doing a nice job right there. Trabulsi moves back in, but then he gets doubled.
Shovels
it
off.
Pass. Nice double by Chris Burt. Ball down.
Hutton goes back to play it now with 20 seconds. So Rutgers has held it for the last 2 minutes. They've yet to get a shot away.
Well, you know, you can slow the pace down, but it doesn't do any good unless you get a shot off.
On the move now is Crost. We're down to 10 seconds. There's the shot. It got the pipe. Syracuse gets it. They should be able to get out of this first quarter without any scoring against them. Almost a shot on goal from one goalie to the other. And that is the end of the first quarter in the dome. With the score, Syracuse 3 and Rutgers nothing.
You're watching Cable 13, the lucky number for you.
And the stats after one quarter of play. Most important, Syracuse leading 3-0.
Yeah, pretty even, actually, throughout that first quarter. Ground balls 10-8. That's a telling statistic. Means both teams are hustling. Man-up goals, 1 to Syracuse, none for Rutgers. We're back now to faceoffs, which may become a statistic because that one was lost by Kotz, but Brannigan.
With a blindside check, and Mark gets it back and starts a break quickly. Tom Nelson to Corey. Good play, Nislansky. Oh, what a check that was from Tom Nelson.
I think they owed one.
Tim Donovan, 18.
Well, they hit trap and knocked him back about 12 yards.
Legged
they
upfield.
Are really putting the body to each other, Dave. This should be an interesting game.
DeSurio signals 2. I think I detected 2 fingers.
It could mean the 2-2-2, which means there'd be 6 players, 6 attackers, including the midfielders, 2 behind, 2 on the goal mouth in the crease, and 2 out front.
Here's a move in close. Good defense. Desco and Opie combining to separate the man.
Trabulsi tried to force that a little bit. There were a lot of people there playing defense on the crease, and he just couldn't go through them all. Good look and a good break.
Syracuse has been breaking well all game, getting the ball up in a hurry, which is one way to do it against a team that's trying to slow you down.
Well, Syracuse should be up 30 unless they... Oh, they're going to give him a slash. Syracuse will be up a minute. Jim O'Hara. Official makes the call, and I thought it might have been a push, but they got him slashing. He did a lot, actually, on the way down. He was all over Brannigan. Yeah, there, right there. He hit him on the head. Good call, Jimmy.
If you just joined us in that first quarter, Syracuse got goals from Tom Corey, Rhett Cavanaugh, and Todd Curry. 3-0.
And they really had to work for him, too. Rutgers is playing good defense also.
Tim Nelson did pick up 1 assist, so he needs 1 more point to become the all-time leading scorer.
As you mentioned, his brother is an assistant coach at Rutgers.
Scott Nelson. Here's Brad Kotz. Corey to Nelson. Will this be it?
A lot of anticipation among the fans. Will it be a goal or an assist?
Here's
might
a
be an assist.
Score.
That should be it. See if they give it to him. That's it. That's the assist. There it is.
There's the goal in right now. Down on the field, Tim Nelson, Roy Simmons, and the entire Syracuse team comes on to congratulate him. Two-time winner of the Trumbull Award as the outstanding attack man in college lacrosse. And what a scene now at midfield as Tim Nelson is surrounded by his teammates.
That's got to make you feel kind of goose pimply as everybody's standing and applauding. And there's the man, started his career in 1982 at North Carolina State. they dropped the sport, and their loss was Syracuse's gain. He transferred to Syracuse and has been a mainstay, two-time All-American. This will be his third.
And there's his brother congratulating him. Scott Nelson congratulating Tim Nelson.
It's kind of, it's nice, it's justice that it's an assist that he gets it on, because that's where he's made his reputation. It's a great ISO, great slow motion. Watch the ball out of his stick. There it is. That's the surgeon, as he just really gets that ball right on the stick of Kotz, and Kotz right between the legs of Neslansky.
You could see four defensive players shift toward him in that shot. Here's an isolated look at that record-setting point.
Yep, he knew it, and he got it right by Bayek, the defenseman, 32, who has done a good job on him so far this game, but that's his second assist, and that was the record setter.
That was not one of the more spectacular assists by Tim Nelson. You're bound to see assists of a more spectacular variety from here on in, but now I'm sure he's glad that
the pressure is off,
whatever pressure there really was, and they can go back to just playing lacrosse without any other thoughts to get in their way. Syracuse leading it 4-0.
Oh, nice shot.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Still will be possession to Rutgers.
I think that was Tim Donovan took a left-handed low bouncer. Not on goal. Trabulsi with the ball. Nice shot from behind. We see him bring the ball in.
Trabulsi, I'm sure, has played some with Tim Nelson, maybe Sandlot, because they weren't in high school at the same time.
Well, you're out of that Yorktown program. I'm sure they know all about each other.
Weak shot, and Tom Nims takes it. Syracuse 4, Rutgers nothing.
Syracuse getting back in the flow, as we said, kind of a week off, and against a Colgate team less than really representative of Division I talent. And they knew that Rutgers was going to be tough, and they have played tough defensively. They have not offered much of an offensive challenge. Syracuse going to clear the ball. Four across. And Rutgers is going to zone them there. Oh, they get the ball to Kavanaugh. Got behind the three men. And defenseman number 31, Pat Dawson, not able to do anything about it.
12 minutes and 4 seconds to go.
Corey with the ball. He's going to get double. There he breaks off. Nice job defensively by Lewis, 35 for Rutgers.
Kavanaugh ducked, and that shot went right into
the
spot.
That could be Kavanaugh. Garbage goal, or Rhett Kavanaugh.
Kavanaugh earned it because he ducked on the initial shot, got out of the way of it, which hit the goalie Neslansky in the chest, and Kavanaugh was right there to swat it home.
Watching Neslansky, we'll see as it progresses. We'll see there's the one shot high, but there's the rebound he can't control. See, he's out of the net. And now watch, you see the end of it as Kavanaugh was able to scoop that ball off the ground and put it in the net. And that's one thing Nims does. It was a great example right there, is he's so good at controlling that rebound, and Neslansky couldn't, and he gave up a goal because of it.
Kavanaugh gets the goal. It's unassisted. Syracuse leads it 5-0.
Ball kept in by Kotz.
Corey and Tom Nelson now contending for it.
Syracuse will retain possession. Tom Nelson chased it out of bounds.
And all the hoopla about the Tim Nelson record, this has been a solid defensive performance to this point by the Orange men.
Absolutely right. Something that I think they've been looking for as they come into the playoffs, they want to peak defensively. Offense always seems to be kind of a constant. The defense has had maybe some ups and downs, and they're looking for some consistency. This is one of their best games defensively for a quarter that I've seen.
Rutgers has gone now two straight games without scoring in the first quarter.
Good pass by Curry, one-handed up to Kotz.
Curry lost his stick at midfield. He's going to be coming into your picture shortly. There he is.
All open on the crease for a second was Tom Nelson. Number five, he's going to swing it around to Curry at the top.
Here's the hard low shot. Syracuse will keep it because there was a man back there.
You know, you got to take those once in a while, Dave, because when you fake it, if you haven't taken one, they don't worry about it. So they take that little wrist shot that hums along the carpet at about 90 miles an hour.
So a Tim Nelson jump up high. Here's another shot. That's not a replay. This is live action.
That's right. It's the same shot. And terms of placement.
Orange mounting the strong attack now. Will Rutgers get it?
Yes, they should.
And they do.
Once again, good hustle by Rick Lewis.
Big sticks come on for Syracuse now. Fred Opie and company.
Number 35, Matt Casciato. Chris Burt, 33.
For those watching, perhaps, for the first time, when we say big sticks, what do we mean exactly?
Well, basically, they're midfielders. It used to be midfielder sticks were shorter and the defensive sticks were real long, but they decided that why play out there? You get the long stick, it's easier to play defense with it, so let's give some midfielders long sticks, and then we'll change them after they, if they knock the ball down and pick it up, we'll put offensive midfielders in. So that's what they started doing about, I'd say, 9 or 10 years ago with a lot of regularity.
Lewis Trapp gets it ahead. Andy Briggs, he's double teamed by Brad and Opie.
Good job.
Rutgers still having trouble getting it back, and now they do.
Good job by the middies as they force them back that big stick midfield.
Neslonsky winging it ahead to Andy Briggs. Here comes Briggs, good move.
Cambria, and now they're going to force him back again.
Now so they run him back.
You can't score when you're running backwards, and it's also a real opportunity if you mishandle the ball to have the offense come up with it. So once again, those midfielders right there, big stick, bigger than a normal midfield stick. Fred Opie's got it. It's a little bit shorter maybe than a normal defensive stick, which is 6 feet in length. Shortest it can be is 40 inches. That's usually what the attack men carry. And the midfielder somewhere in between. But the big stick minis carry those large, long sticks. Helps them play defense.
Rutgers redirects, trying to get something started, trying to mount an offense.
Boy, they're all over them. This is a good ride for Syracuse. Really forcing.
Lewis Trapp ahead to Trabulsi. They're in good position now to crack the ice. The feet in front, Trabulsi mishandles, a little bit behind him. And the Orange with Chris Bruno, 44 in there.
Oh, there's a lot of pushing and shoving. You hear the aluminum down there.
Shades of a rugby scrum right there.
That's right.
Here's Darryl Jones, number one.
You know, you're a lot better off with those aluminum sticks than used to be in those because they used to have those big hickory and ash sticks, wood. Boy, they really hurt.
Andy
of course,
Briggs,
that still hurts.
It'll be a delayed call coming up against Chris Burt and Syracuse. So Rutgers now working for a good shot. Hutton is 27. He gets the pass. And he gets hit on the head, and that'll stop play.
They are. Burt, when he slashed him, I think he ripped his shirt. It was like a razor cut. He really hit him with the head of that stick.
Penalty is on Chris Burt.
So he'll be down a minute.
1 minute.
And at the end, it was a little bit on the head. Neither team being especially shy. We'll see the slash. And boy, that really, really hurts. And up high on the shoulder. Does force him back though, doesn't it? But it costs him a minute.
Rutgers now with a man advantage. 5-0 Syracuse lead. Rutgers after this game has to face Johns Hopkins, so they cannot afford, well, a loss here and certainly not a loss then, and have any hopes of getting into the 8-team Division I playoff format.
They're currently ranked 14th, but that doesn't always mean anything. And when it comes to the playoff selection, as we say, they got a lot of time to go before the final rankings come out.
Bashirio, 26, is outside. There's
Feeds
a feed the inside
there
and
the
score.
Go.
In there nicely is Jeff Lynch to score for Rutgers.
That is a tough place. Syracuse has been real tough at taking the crease away from Rutgers. But when you're down a man, of course, it's a little bit tougher. And we'll see if Lynch, the junior out of Nyack, watch the feed. There's a nice feed from Trabulsi. And Syracuse outnumbered. And that's what that slash will do to you. It gives you up a man for a minute, and you give up a goal.
Good move by Lynch as he went to the vacant spot in the defense and got the pass. 5-1 Syracuse. Tom Martello, number 19, still with the ball. Now he goes cross field to DeSherio.
DeSherio may take the long shot.
Oh, man, is he wrapped up and dropped?
It was Curry, I think. Todd Curry all over him. And he get a hold on that. That'll cost you 30, Todd. Gee, you know, if you do it right, sometimes you can get away with it. Let's see if this was obvious at all.
All legal so far.
Yeah,
there
right.
You go.
Excuse me while I take your head off.
Number 16.
And I don't see Curry involved in too many of those kind of plays.
No, you know, I think he thought what happened was Rutgers man drove back into him and he got more than he wanted. He just wanted a stick, got his head. So Syracuse now man down for 30 more seconds.
And a goal here would bring the Scarlet Knights back into it. They were down 5-0. It's now 5-1. Here's Lynch, who has the game's only goal, number 10. Only goal for Rutgers, that is. Feet in front, same kind of play. Ground ball shot,
there's
Nims
that.
Gets it.
Good job by Nims.
Tricks it on the head and he's dropped. They call it a slash.
We'll see if it's all the same. Should cost them a minute.
Tripping penalty against number 14.
There's the pass up. There's the shot. Watch the rebound. He's right on top of it. He usually doesn't let him get that far away. And then as he goes around, watch Trabulsi over the head. But there's the foot. He tripped him. That'll cost him a minute. And Syracuse will get the ball at the midfield line. They are even until Todd Curry makes it back in the game. I'm not sure how much time he has in his penalty. But they're even right now. Syracuse may wait for a second. Now Curry's in the game. So Syracuse is man up.
Tim Nelson goes behind the net. Brad Kotz with something to say to Curry as he comes on. Tom Corey now to Tim Nelson, who already has come up with the 2 points to set the all-time Division I scoring record.
Syracuse has started with a 1-3-2. Three men on the crease, one man behind. Now they shift and really...
Tim Nelson overthrows, and the battle is on. Now the Rutgers half of the field. A Syracuse man comes out of the pack, Mike O'Donnell, back to Nims.
Right
Nims
back
quickly
up.
Back upfield, Emmett Prina. Emmett, will he crank it? He dishes off. Kotz's shot is smothered. And Curry there, their nice feed back. And Corey puts it in. Great look on the return pass. Tom just sort of rolled it right in.
Watch the left hand of Corey when he finally gets the ball. There's the initial
Syracuse
grab by Curry.
42.
Backward
Tom
pass.
Corey.
Watch that left hand. Boom.
Just a soft shot Tom by Tom Corey. Corey.
Yep, there was the start of all. The rebound by Kotz. Corey, watch the backhand. There it is. And here's the little soft left hand net rippler.
You think those guys have played together before?
I think they have. Eric Jeske's midfield in now. Picked up the faceoff. So Jeske, number 11.
Second goal of the game for Tom Corey. On the year, Tom now has 16 goals, which puts him third in the goal parade behind the Nelson brothers.
Or
I should say behind Tom Nelson and Brad Kotz.
The Syracuse shot, not much on the ball, will give the Scarlet Knights and Rutgers the opportunity to clear with 5:37 left to go in this first half.
6-1. Rutgers really hasn't been able to slow the pace down as much as we might have thought. Syracuse clearing quickly to take away that possibility.
Also, as we said, offensively, Rutgers not able to put a lot of pressure on, although they've had a number of man-up opportunities, but not much in the fast break department.
Now to Zlonsky, to Bayek. On the side to Lewis Trapp. Overthrown and taken away by the Orange. Here they come. See how quickly they transition today.
That's right, and that really hurts Rutgers.
Intercepted. And the Knights come back upfield. Knocked away from Martello. Jeff Lynch plays it, number 10. Here's the feed and a score. In the middle, a good feed and the score by number 29, Brian Crost.
They let Crost penetrate. It was a fast break. They were dropping back into position. And
offside.
Oh, how about
some
that?
Offsides.
Ryan Crost, the leading goal scorer for Rutgers. And now they say the goal is good.
Well, then the offside must have been against Syracuse. So the technical foul penalty is wiped out by the goal. If it were a personal foul that Syracuse had committed, then the goal would be good, as they would also have to suffer the man-down situation for a minute.
So it's the second Rutgers goal of the game. Jeff Lynch, now Brian Cross. Syracuse leads 6-2.
By number 29, Brian Cross, with an assist to number 10, Jeff Lynch.
Lynch got the assist on that second goal.
You can see how important the faceoffs are as the Rutgers has been able to come up with this and quiet down that Syracuse offense.
Greg Freed moving with it, moving by Pat Donahue.
They try to feed the crease. Nobody open. Ball way down.
Tom Nelson tried to stay onside, but he was not successful.
As soon as he went over and his hands, fine, your stick is part of your, you could be all right, but as soon as you try to get up and you put any other part of your body down, you're going to be offside. That's exactly what happened.
We've got 4 minutes and 11 seconds to play in the first half. At halftime, we'll be talking to Roy Simmons, Sr., the man whose name is synonymous with lacrosse. I think this game has had a few changes in the last couple of years.
That's right.
I'm sure he'll be able to talk about it in some depth. And Roy's always got a few stories. John Hutton moving against Pratt. Nims is down for the save. O'Donnell comes out of there.
Transition again. Ball down a little bit. Not Bird after it. And Bruno 44 there, but not able to get to it in time.
Darrell Jones, number one for Rutgers. Syracuse has had to play only one game in, what, a week or 10 days, and so they should be fresh in terms of the legs, and the transition game has really been evidence of that today.
There's Bruno, 44, ball down. Mike O'Donnell eventually up, but they could not come up with it.
3.5 to go, first half. It's a 6-2 Syracuse lead. Oh, they lost a man, and there's the score. Brad Fish out of Fayetteville, Manlius. Got away from his man, and he beat Tom Nims from in close one-on-one.
That was just a case of one-on-one, and I believe that was Desco, 27, that got beat. And Fish, you can see right there, he has already beaten Desco, and he's up in the air and over the inside shoulder of goalie Nims, so 6-3. And once again, we say that able to control the ball and come up with that score should put Rutgers right back into it.
Right now, we'll pause for systems identification. You're watching Syracuse Lacrosse live on Cable 13.